on that group. Is it still just a small cross-party group, or have you had discussions about who else should be on? Councillor Mitchell reported at the October meeting that you were awaiting a conclusive, credible, achievable proposal from the football club and their backers. And once again, we're asking, who are the backers? We need to know this. The spoken report that he issued was also said that the Town Council owns a substantial community asset which is crying out to be managed as a sports and leisure facility and not as blocks of flats and houses. And I think we all say amen to that. As some of the 12 acres of green open space were covenanted to the Town Council as public open space for the enjoyment of the town's residents, I believe that the Town Council should think of themselves as the space's guardians rather than an asset in the monetary sense. It already is a sports and leisure facility to which anyone and everyone has access for cricket, football, kite flying, picnics, all sorts of inclusive outdoor uses. If it becomes something like a David Lloyd type sports centre, that is exclusive, expensive, with large buildings, tarmac for the car parking. So we need answers to that question. Is that what is being thought of, as opposed to the houses and the flats? Residents of Bristol Road have had notices put on their properties that we've made ourselves saying no to lots of playing fields. Because I just think it's irresponsible for the council to be thinking in terms of getting rid of the only flat piece of green land useful for sports that you actually have in your ownership. I think that's correct.
You've got half a minute left.
Thank you very much. I think you just need to try and take a decision at the earliest opportunity to stop the outside avaricious agencies whose main focus is a large profit at the expense of the town. Thank you.